So the shields are an extra added layer of protection for any situation that we may encounter at our campuses. The beauty of the shields is that we were able to get funding from the state to actually give one to every single one of our officers that works for the district. Not having to wait for an officer that actually has a shield. Any officer responding, as soon as they get there, that shield is going to be ready to go to engage and take out any active threat that we have on the campus. We had been training for this before. Prior to getting the award and actually receiving our shields, we had already sent two officers to become shield instructors. We don't have to rely on an outside agency to do the training for us, since we're not just going to train once a year at the end of, or at the beginning of the school year. We're going to be pulling them out throughout the school year just to keep that fresh in the back of their mind and making sure that they're the tip of the spear when it comes to activating these shields. Every single one of our officers is issued standard equipment. Everybody has the same equipment across the board. That way we're not having to wait for somebody else with something to come forward. We want to be able to be self-sustained. We have officers that teach active shooter, the alert active shooter training, and they're teaching with the Texas Department of Public Safety, with agencies from across the state down here to our local police department. So having those assets, having the experience that the officers have, you know, we have trained hostage negotiators. We're up to 8 now on our team. We have trained SWAT members. We have canine trained instructors. We're about to send an officer to become a mental health instructor so that our officers can become certified mental health officers within the district. All the officers that we have a vast amount of networks, not just with the 3 municipalities, but state, sheriff's office, you know, with the constables that are out here patrolling with us today, with border health. Having that connectivity with them is really, really key, because they're going to be our backup when we don't have an incident like this. But we're going to be training with them just as much as we're training with our officers to have that interchangeability.
Not about quantity of shots going down, it's about quality of shots going down.
Our purpose is to make sure that the teachers in the classroom feel safe, that the students feel safe coming to school every day, that any of our staff members feel safe throughout the districts. Having that support, again, from the board, from the superintendent, even from the local surrounding communities, is really what's key in driving where we're going with this department and what we're doing as a police department.